Greetings. Greetings, brother. Thank you for your comment about Isaiah 29, 11, and 12. It is a closed book? No, it says it is a sealed book. Closed and sealed do not mean the same thing. So your fundamental assertion is that sealed does not mean the same as closed. And you graciously provide definitions of closed and sealed to make your point. Closed means the front and rear covers of the book are shut, the pages jammed hard up against one another, and impossible to read. Okay, I appreciate your definition of closed. Sealed means the content or message of the book is at completion, as in there is no more revelation or information to come, or no more words or pages to be added. The book is complete, the message sealed in its finality, as in exactly what Muslims claim the Quran to be when they call it the seal of revelation. After it, there will come no more revelation. I understand this is an Islamic definition, which reuses seal or sealed because Muhammad has applied the word to himself as the seal of the prophets. I admire the passion and zeal with which you present your ideas. Unfortunately, brother, you do not know the details of the matter about which you speak, nor does Islam want you to, because that serves their purpose. However, you make a mistake because you are not thorough in your research or thinking, brother. The English word closed has multiple meanings. These are from dictionary.com, just so you can look them up if you want. 1. Having or forming a boundary or barrier. Example, he was blocked by a closed door, or the house had a closed porch. Brought to a close, concluded. Example, it was a closed incident with no repercussions. This definition is actually a synonym to sealed, concluded, brought to a close, completed. Not public, restricted, exclusive. A closed meeting, for example. A closed bid at a private auction. This definition matches the closed book. Access is restricted. 4. Not open to new ideas or arguments. Example, the mind of the believer was closed to logic and new facts. The English word sealed also has multiple meanings. These also from dictionary.com. 1. An embossed emblem, figure, symbol, word, letter, etc., used as attestation or evidence of authenticity. 2. A stamp, medallion, ring, etc., engraved with such a device for impressing paper, wax, lead, or the like. 3. To close by any form of fastening that must be broken before access can be gained. 4. To fasten or close tightly or as if by a seal. This definition is a synonym to closed. The English words closed and sealed share some common definitions, meaning they can be synonymous or can be synonyms. You favor the definition of sealed that you learned regarding Muhammad. Islam claims Muhammad is the seal of the prophets, meaning the conclusion or completion of the line of prophets. So you unconsciously think completed when you read the word seal or sealed. But let us see if that makes any sense, brother. The passage you attempt to explain is Isaiah 29, verse 11 and 12. Starting at verse 10, the Lord has brought over you a deep sleep. He has sealed your eyes, the prophets. He has covered your heads, the seers. For you, this whole vision is nothing but words sealed in a scroll. And if you give the scroll to someone to read and say, "Please read this," they will answer, "I can't, it is sealed." Or if you give the scroll to someone who cannot read and say, "Read this, please," they will answer, "I don't know how to read." To be consistent, I use the NIV for all three verses, and that preserves the approach the translators applied. Let's look at these verses together because they are related. The Lord has brought over you a deep sleep. He has sealed your eyes. He has covered your heads. For you, this whole vision is nothing but words sealed in a scroll. And if you give the scroll to someone who can read and say, please read this, they will answer, I can't, it is sealed. Or if you give the scroll to someone who cannot read and say, read this please, they will answer, I don't know how to read. The word translated sealed occurs three times. Sealed your eyes, words sealed in a scroll, and I can't, it is sealed. You think sealed means completed, so let us read the passage that way. The Lord has brought over you a deep sleep. He has completed your eyes. Does that even make any sense, that Yahweh God has completed the eyes? No, that statement is irrational, and worse in this context. Completing the eyes would mean they could see, the opposite of God's message to them. But their eyes being closed makes perfect sense. For you, this whole vision is nothing but words completed in a scroll. Your argument is to see the word completed here. But a completed vision is a good thing. It would be bad for an incomplete vision. For you, this whole vision is nothing but words completed in a scroll. And next, the book is given to a literate person, one who can read. And if you give the scroll to someone who can read and say, read this please, but the man who can read says he cannot read the book or the scroll, the text, they will answer, I can't. It is completed. But it makes no sense for a man who can read to say he cannot read a scroll or book because it is completed, finished, whole, entire, all there. That rationale would be irrational. So claiming sealed means completed is entirely wrong to having any kind of rational meaning to the message. On the other hand, using the correct definition of sealed, meaning closed, creates a perfectly coherent message from the prophet of Yahweh God. You wrote, closed means the front and rear covers of the book are shut, the pages jammed hard up against one another, and impossible to read. Now, an obvious question is, why doesn't the learned man simply open the book? Is the foundation of your whole argument that a learned man who can read cannot think of the first, most obvious action when handed a closed book? And if you give the scroll to someone who can read and say, read this, they will answer, I can't, it is closed. Why doesn't the learned man simply open the book? Most books are carried closed and handed to another person closed. And if it were handed opened to the page to read, he would not declare, it is closed. Nor would he declare, it is completed, finished. In reality, if you hand an open book to a man who can read and say, read this, the implication is the passage the book is opened to. And yet it remains that a learned man who can read declares he cannot read a book handed to him. Something prevents him. Something obstructs him from reading. And that is why there is an obvious implication the book is not just closed, but sealed shut. But the best way to understand is simply to examine the original Hebrew. The Hebrew word translated sealed in Isaiah 29:11 is chatum. I cannot, for sealed is it. Chatum. It's in the lexicon number 2856. Chatam. To seal, affix a seal, or seal up. That's the definition. The translations are obstructs, seal, sealed, seals, sets a seal, shut. The subtle distinction between closed and sealed is an implication of obstruction. Something more than just being closed, it is prevented from being opened. We are not told what the obstruction is. It could be a physical mechanism to prevent access, like a seal. It could be a language the man cannot read, but then we would expect a different declaration. I cannot read this. It is in a language I do not know and cannot read. He did not say this, so we logically dismiss this possibility. So, brother, it is appropriate to use the word sealed, but it is illogical to think the word sealed means completed. And I believe the source of your confusion and error is the word sealed itself. It is because you were told Isaiah 29:12 is mention of Muhammad. So the claims you have been told of Muhammad are dominant in your mind. You are told Muhammad is the seal of the prophets. So your mind has only considered the Islamic definitions of seal programmed into your thinking. Sealed means the content or message of the book is at completion, as in there is no more revelation or information to come, or no more words or pages to be added. The book is complete, the message sealed in its finality, as in exactly what Muslims claim the Quran to be when they call it the seal of revelation. After it, there will come no more revelation. And that is why it is always risky to apply Islamic definitions where no Islamic concepts exist. Islamic definitions are wrong, brother, and anyone with an open, logical mind can see completed is the wrong meaning to assume. But a mind sealed, obstructed, closed by Satan will hold on to the false and illogical definitions. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.